Hello everyone, another video of life lessons from the tennis court. Cloudy today, rainy day, still playable, so it's good. And I'm wearing some fluo colors so my opponent can see me. Today the lesson is more about coaching or parenting, and for you to coach yourself, parent yourself. This is the thing. I get a lot of parents coming to me with their kids. They want their kids to be champions. And sometimes they come with knowing that my kid is the next best thing. Sometimes they come asking, is my kid good enough? Does my kid has what it takes? And we have conversations. But in the end, I know better. It's not so much what the parent wants for the kid, as much as what the kid wants for him or herself. So when I am with kids on the tennis court, I check that they love tennis, they like to play, they like to listen, they apply, they are good kids, and kind of do things, no? That like there is something to build on. The lesson to you with what I am saying is, when you do things, do you do them for yourself? Because you enjoy them? Because you feel like a kid that you can be doing that thing all day, all night, and when you go to sleep, you can't wait for the next day to start again? Or you are doing something out of obligation, out of to please others, out of convenience, like ulterior motives. This can be in business, this can be when you participate in your community, this can even be with your own hobby. Like something you like to do when nobody's looking? Is that thing that you are doing really your own? Or is it something that you do out of tradition? Something that someone put on you when you are younger, probably, and now you are just following the motions? There is always time to be yourself. That's what I wanna preach with this video. I remember I had a kid one time. I loved this kid. He was so good playing tennis. He was really good, talented. He was 6, something like that. And always on the court, he wanted to play soccer. And even in tennis, when he hit a good shot, he used to shout names of soccer players. So I approached him and I said, what's up with you and soccer? And he said, I love soccer. So I started to put in more soccer into our tennis lessons. Soccer is still good for footwork, agility, ability, discipline. When kids are that young, it doesn't matter what it is so much, as long as it builds on their talents that they need. And soccer collaborates a lot into building a tennis player. And one day I asked him, why you don't tell your parents you wanna go to soccer academy instead of tennis academy? And he said, well, you know, my sister plays tennis, so they bring me along. Along with the sister. Families, it's difficult, I understand. Your kid wants to play soccer one place, your other kid wants to play tennis in another place. You have to make a Salomonic decision. But in the end, my point is, pay attention to the deep desires of your kid, if you are a parent, or your kid inside, if you are your own parent, adult of yourself. And the way to know about that kid in you is, what is it that you do that makes you smile? What is it that you can be doing all day? You never get tired because there is no time, there is no nothing against it. You solve every problem. You want to keep doing it no matter what. That thing that makes you smile and makes you wanting to, you want to do it over and over and over and over again, that's your kid inside. No matter your age, find it and live fantastic.